Boxing champion Andy Ruiz is answering Tyson Fury, who said that he would beat Andy Ruiz with one hand tied behind his back. So Andy Ruiz says, after that performance of Tyson Fury against Otto Wallin, there's no way he beats me with one hand tied behind his back. Andy Ruiz, of course, is responding to what Tyson Fury said, that he would beat Andy Ruiz with one hand tied behind his back. Obviously, it's not the case. Andy Ruiz is a champion. He stopped Joshua, and Joshua is a monster, a gold medalist, an Olympian, a champion, a person that stopped Klitschko. Tyson Fury beat Klitschko, but he didn't stop him. And for Otto Wallin, this was a performance of a lifetime. Came out of nowhere, almost caused the upset. I was at the StubHub covering the Jaime Munguia fight, and there was a room packed of reporters gathered around the phone, all watching in the last round. And I'll be honest, all the reporters were cheering for Otto Wallin. Happy for the kid, happy for Dmitry Salida. Dmitry actually said last week that come Sunday, Otto Wallin will be one of the biggest names in sports. And he definitely made a big name for himself. Tyson Fury, it was a life and death battle. He pulled it off. He had a nasty gash over his head and a second cut on the eyelid. He got stitches. He is okay. There was some criticism of Tyson's corner, but I don't believe you should attack a corner. End of the day, people are going to go to BoxRec in 6 months or a year, and they're going to look, was it a win or a loss? The details are gone. And if a person has already success, 2-3 fights, you don't fire them for one fight, because there could be a lot of factors. Maybe Fury didn't step up for this fight and he thought it was too easy. Maybe Otto Wallin is way better than what people thought he was. Injuries happen. It's part of the sport. It's boxing. There's no timeouts. Great job by Tyson Fury's cutman, by the way, for stopping the bleeding and doing such a phenomenal job. I just saw a meme right now. It's pretty funny. It was Derek Chisora, who in a press conference said they're trying to F him without Vaseline, and it was a split screen, and then you had all the Vaseline and Fury's eyebrow. It was funny. It was, you got to laugh, because whoever created it was very creative and it was a sense of humor. But the bottom line is, as bad as the cut was bothering Tyson Fury, as bad as the cut was nasty, it reminded me of Klitschko's cut when he fought Lennox Lewis, and that fight was stopped and Lennox Lewis won. This fight was not stopped. And it was a great job by the corner. Fury, of course, went straight to the hospital after the fight, and they took care of him. I saw a lot of arguments back and forth today on social media. Was it right of ESPN to tell Tyson Fury's corner that it was a punch and not headbutt? Because if the fight stops and they think it's a headbutt, then it's no contest. If it's a punch, then it's an automatic loss. Tyson Fury's an ESPN fighter, and ESPN have signed them. Commission could have told the corner just as well. So whether it matters if the media tell him or the commission, in the end of the day, Tyson Fury won, so it's a moot point. This would be a point if they stopped the fight and the corner thought it was a headbutt and then was shocked to find out that it's not, then it's an issue. But the fight wasn't stopped, and Tyson Fury survived this one and continues on to the next one. So there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa Beck reporting.